Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about exemption section 10 subsection 10c, that is related to exemption of compensation received by the employee in the name of VRS compensation. We already discussed about what do you mean by VRS, what do you mean by compensation, what are the conditions. Now we have to discuss about how much amount of exemption is available in the hands of the employee out of his retirement compensation. For that, as per section 10 subsection 10c, we have to go the three different amount. First we have to calculate three different amount, then we have to calculate which is the least amount, because the minimum of these three amount is considered as exemption. The excess compared to the actual amount of compensation is taxable, that's it. So let us discuss one by one. What is the first item? The first item is actual amount of compensation received as per the guidelines. So as we discussed here before, there is a guideline for the purpose of VRS compensation. So as per the guideline, employee is receiving, is able to receive, eligible to receive. First you have to take how much he is receiving as a compensation. It's given in the question while you are going to calculate the illustration. It's given, that is the first one. And second one, statutory limit. As of now, the statutory limit is rupees 5 lakh. So while discussing the amount of exemption, the least of three things. First one, I already told you, that is as per the guidelines, what is the amount of compensation is received. And the second one, the statutory limit of rupees 5 lakh. And the third one, that most important thing, the two things are there. The higher of these two amount is considered as a third point. First point actual, second point statutory limit 5 lakh, and third one, we are having two things. Out of these two, which is higher, that has to be taken. The higher of the two things. First one, the last one salary, that should be multiplied by 3 and should be multiplied by number of fully completed years of service. The three things are there in the first point. First one is last drawn salary. Last drawn salary in the sense at the time of VRS. So before the month, he should take into consider what is the salary has taken. That has to be taken. That is called as last month salary drawn. That should be multiplied by 3. That is standard. And should be multiplied by number of completed years of service. It's very simple. Completed years of service in the sense, if it is in excess of 6 months, should not be considered. For example, if he is working for 15 years and 7 months, we should ignore 7 months. We have to take into consider 15 years. Suppose if he is working 14 years and 3 months, we have to take 14 years only. In the sense, we have to take into consider fully completed year service. So not fraction, not in excess thereof. So that is the first amount. So what is that? We have to take into consider last month's salary drawn into 3 into the completed years of service. Or second one, last drawn salary into balance of number of months of services left. Second is also most important. In the first one, we have to take into consider number of completed years of service, but here we have to take into consider remaining months of service. Say for example, if he is working in a particular employer with a particular employer certain year, but still he is having some remaining months, because I told you in the beginning, VRS is nothing but retirement from his service before the date of retirement, because the date of retirement is fixed on the basis of his date of birth. But if he is retired before the date, how many months are there remaining? That has to be taken. That is the second point here. So that is the last month's salary drawn into what is the number of months remaining of his services. Say for example, he is completed on 18 years of service. He is still having 3 years of service. So 3 years of service in the sense, 3 years, that should be multiplied by 12, because 1 year 12 months. So 3 into 12, 36 months has to be taken. We should not take it as year, because we have to multiply it by number of months. That is second one. Out of these two, which is the higher amount? That should be the third point. I repeat, first point is actual amount, or second one is statutory limit 5 lakh, and third one, higher of these two. Higher of these two in the sense, first one, last month salary drawn into 3 into number of completed years of service, or last month salary drawn into remaining months of his services. Out of these two, which is higher? That is the third point. And out of these three points, which is the amount is least that is eligible to claim as exemption. Few more points are there. Voluntary retirement compensation received from the employer being an individual, firm, HUF, association person, etc. is fully taxable in the hands of the employee. That's most important. There is no exemption if an employee is receiving the VRS compensation from the employer, if the employer is an individual, an HUF, an firm or association person. If he is working under this kind of employer, there is no exemption, fully taxable. What we discussed here before, except this kind of employer. Then certain guidelines are there. So as we discussed earlier also, VRS must be applicable to all employees who have either completed age of 40 years or has completed 10 years of service. That is most important. Who is eligible to receive VRS? One is, he should cross minimum 40 years of service, 40 years of age, or minimum 10 years of service. Either he may have more than 10 years of service, he is eligible. If his age is more than 40 years, he is eligible. That is the first condition, guidelines. Second one, vacancy caused by VRS not to be filled up. As we discussed here before, it should not be filled up because of vacancy due to VRS. And the third one, the retiring employee should not get an employment in another concern belong to the same management. That is most important. Say for example, if he is working under A company. So if he is working under A company at Bangalore, if he is taking VRS and he is residing at Bangalore, and he is having the same company's another branch, if he is working there, he is not eligible to claim the exemption. He should not get any employment of the same management. If he is getting the same employment of the same management, he is not eligible to claim the VRS scheme. So that is the rules. If you want to claim the VRS, he should not take another employment of the same management. He can take another management, but not under the same management. And I told in the beginning, specified employer. Then who are the specified employer? It's very simple. Any company, state or central government establishment, local authority, cooperative society, specified universities, IIMs of all the states, IITs of all the states. These are called as specified employers. If an employee taking the VRS and working under specified employer, these are all the specified employer. I repeat. Company, any establishment of state or central government, local authority, cooperative society, IIMs and IITs. Students, today we have discussed the computation of exemption under section 10, subsection 10C in the name of VRS compensation scheme and compensation received under VRS scheme. So we can calculate amount of VRS and amount of exempted through illustrations.